So you're thinking of moving to Waterloo, Ontario, and not sure about the price point and, you know, what your budget might fit and what it can get you here in Waterloo, Ontario? Well, that's exactly what we're gonna do here in this particular video. I'm gonna actually show you around Waterloo, Ontario. I'm gonna do what we always do, which is taking you on a tour of through some neighborhoods, show you some different homes of different price points, so you can see what may fit with your budget. And we're gonna get after it right now. If this is your first time to this channel and you want to know everything about living, eating, playing, sleeping, dining in Kitchener, Waterloo, Cambridge, and the surrounding towns, then subscribe below and tap the bell for notification so you can be the first to learn about the current market in Kitchener, Cambridge, Waterloo, and surrounding towns. My name is Dharmik Dixit. I'm a local real estate agent serving Kitchener, Cambridge, Waterloo, and the towns around it. I do get calls, texts, emails from people just like you looking for help in making their move to Kitchener, Cambridge, Waterloo, and the towns around it, and I absolutely love it. So whether you're thinking of moving in 9 days or 90 days, give me a call, shoot me a text, send me an email, schedule a Zoom call. All the information is in the description below so I can help you make a smooth move to Kitchener, Cambridge, Waterloo, and the surrounding towns.
So as you can see right behind me, I'm at the Waterloo Town Square, which is located in the uptown Waterloo area. And you know, it's, you know, I'm gonna turn around. This is the you know, the main street in the uptown Waterloo, where a lot of local shops and the dining options are located. And you know, as I drive from here to our first property, I'll actually drive you around with me, so you will get to see what I'm talking about. At the same time, right behind me in there, you will see some local shops. There's a place called Shops at the Uptown Waterloo Square, which is kind of an indoor small shopping center. Which is great for some, you know, small shopping, and at the same time, like, you know, this place usually is happening. There are usually events happening all the time in this place. Right now I'm here on a weekday morning, so it's not that crazy, but you know, if you were to check this place out on a weekend or like on a holiday, usually there is always something or another happening. Plenty of attention to local artists. Many of them do actually play here at the same time. I mean, last time I was here about a month ago, and you know, there were musical swings which were here, and me and my family, my 2.5-year-old, we enjoyed, we had a great time just hanging out in this place. Nothing too fancy, but you know, just a purely a great time in the outdoor space where people gather and, you know, have a great time, grab a coffee from a local store. There's actually an ice cream store that you must check out if you're ever in this area. It's called Four All Ice Cream. Some of the best ice creams, like flavors as well, very unique flavors, and the best ice cream. Beer Town is great. Piper Arms is great as well. Plenty of options. But like I said, many other options. I can keep going on and on when it comes to the dining options in Waterloo. And you know, the best part is they're very, very diverse, right? So you will find a dining and cuisine for every ethnicity, whatever you are into and whatever you like. There is a local dining option you will definitely find in Waterloo. Even we are not too far off from the, you know, the university area, and you know, as you head down on the university, around that again you will find plenty of things happening at the same time. So you know, that pretty much wraps up this particular part of it. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do what I always do, which is drive you around through this uptown Waterloo strip, so you will get to see, you know, what I'm referring to in terms of the local shops and the dining options. And you know, we're gonna head down to our first property and let's get right after it.
All right, so we are at our first stop here in Waterloo, and this is the house with a price range of $699,000, so just under $700,000. And this is located right in the, you know, Lincoln Village, which is very close to where we were actually. It's about a 10-minute drive. And this is a freehold townhome, three bedroom, three washrooms, just under 1,400 square feet, 1,391 to be exact. And I'm gonna show you, you know, I'm gonna turn around and show you right, you're right behind me. That's the house we are looking at right behind me. So that's a three bedroom, three washroom, two-story freehold townhome, listed at $699,000 here in Waterloo. You know, it's very close to Highway 85. So about the highway connectivity. So Waterloo as a town, the main highway for Waterloo is Highway 85. It has five interchanges. You know, if we were to head south on Highway 85, you will be connecting, eventually it becomes like, you know, converts into Highway 7, into the Kitchener. And if you go further, it's gonna go eastbound Highway 8, which connects further down to eastbound Highway 401. And on the, you know, on the other side, if we ever do go Highway 85 on the north end, it does actually connect you to, you know, Elmira, St. Jacobs. I think it does end in Elmira, and, you know, it does become Regional Road 85 past the Waterloo. So that's a bit about the highway connectivity. This particular house that I just showed you is, you know, with the $700,000 price point and, you know, the size of around 1,400, puts you just at around $500 per square feet price point, which is pretty decent considering the fact that you are in the heart of Waterloo, an established and mature neighborhood, and actually very close to the University Avenue, which is where, you know, a lot of things are happening, and you have lots of options in terms of, you know, getting around, dining, shopping, even the nightlife. That's, you know, where you will be looking at most of the nightlife happening as well, is around the University Avenue. So that's, you know, just to tell you a bit about this particular neighborhood. At the same time, what I'm gonna do is next I'm gonna head down to a property which is going to be in the 900,000 price range. So that will give you a decent idea as to what that 900, 950 price point can get you here in Waterloo. And let's get after it right now. But before that, I'm also gonna show you around this particular neighborhood as I drive down from this property to the next, so you get a decent idea of the neighborhood itself as well. And let's go right there. All right, so we are at the second stop in the Westville community. This home that I'm gonna approach very shortly is a $900,000 listed property, sitting on a 4,200 square feet lot. It's a four level backsplit bungalow with the living space of just under 2,000 square feet, actually 1,981 to be exact. And you know, with that price point of $900,000 that it's listed at, you're looking at per square feet price range of just around that $450 per square feet, which is pretty good considering the fact that you are in a, you know, one of the nice neighborhoods in Waterloo. And you know, at the same time, the house has like four bedrooms, so three bedrooms on the main level, there's another level where there's another bedroom, and so four bedroom, three full washrooms is what you're looking at, almost a double garage. And this is the house you're looking at right behind me. That's the one I'm referring to. Which is pretty good for this price point, like I said. And, you know, I'm gonna turn around and show you from this angle as well. So, you know, also giving you a nice look, you know, about the street. As you can see, it's fall season, so you can see the leaves lying on some lawns. But, you know, overall, very well established neighborhood, very well connected to all the amenities as well. Getting around in Waterloo is not that difficult. I mean, you know, the fact that it has two great universities, the public transit, and getting around within the town and even within the region of Waterloo to Grand River Transit is actually pretty good. You know, it has plenty of express routes. It has, you know, LRT service that started like recently last, you know, few years, which has a very good connectivity and actually connects you to major spots in all the three cities. So, you know, getting around through public transit is also, you know, quite accessible. It's definitely getting better day by day. At the same time, I mean, if you have family, you know, if you're looking for good schools, Waterloo is actually home to some great schools. One of the best schools, you know, are located in the Laurelwood neighborhood, you know, which is actually very sought after in Waterloo and very highly spoken about. And, you know, I'll take you through that neighborhood, the next property. So you'll get a decent idea of that. And that's going to be the price point of around 1.1, 1.2. So, you know what, let's head down there. I'll show you around this particular neighborhood while I go from here to there. And let's go after it right now. All right, so we are at our final stop here. And as I promised, this is the Laurelwood neighborhood in Waterloo, one of the most sought after neighborhoods in Waterloo with some great schools, you know, a combination of both new and the old construction. So, you know, that's the best part about the, you know, Waterloo and the Tri-Cities is the fact that, you know, you will get a combination of both new and the dated construction. So, you know, depending on what you're looking for, I'm pretty sure like you can find something that fits your needs in terms of both the new construction or some people wanting to move into well-established neighborhoods, you can get that as well. And talking about this particular house that I'm gonna show you shortly, this is a you know double garage detached home listed at 1.3, just under 1.3, four bedroom, three washrooms, sitting on just under 7,000 square feet lot size. And you know the house itself is just under 2,500 square feet. So you know coming to the price range per square feet, it's putting us at just that $520 per square foot range, which is you know if you compare to the other two homes that we just saw, you might notice that you know it's slightly priced higher per square foot range. That is partly because of the fact that A, this particular home is new, it's 2015 built, and second thing is also the fact that the neighborhood is, you know, comparatively, this is, you know, more sought after neighborhood. Not that the other two neighborhoods were bad. It's just that, you know, this neighborhood has more demand because of some of the great amenities like schools and stuff like that. You know, I'm going to show you right behind me. That's the home that you're looking at. And that's, you know, the one I'm referring to. Double garage detached, as you can see, huge lot, just under 7,000 square feet. And, you know, interestingly, this whole, you know, I'm going to turn around, this whole cul-de-sac is backing onto the, you know, the green space. So it's actually, you know, surrounded by the record, like, you know, the hiking trails. And, you know, there's nothing, no neighboring homes in the back. Although in this particular area, there is quite a bit of new construction that's happening. There are a few active builders in the Kitchener-Waterloo region. So, you know, like I said, depending on what you're looking for, some people looking to move into a completely new neighborhoods. Well, you can have that too. While, you know, there are some older neighborhoods. This particular location, you're very close to actually the boardwalk, which is, you know, at the border of Kitchener and Waterloo. It does fall in Waterloo. Costco is literally next door. And, you know, it has some big box stores and, you know, outdoor shopping mall. So, you know, like it has a lot of stores and a lot of shopping options in the boardwalk area. Waterloo itself does have an indoor shopping mall, one and only Conestoga Mall, which is located in the Waterloo. And, you know, it's again an indoor shopping mall where you get your, you know, decent shopping options. But again, if you have to do your, you know, fancy pants shopping, you could always drive down to a place like, you know, Toronto Premium Outlet is there in Milton, which is not too far. And if you could always go to all the way to, you know, Toronto Egypt Center or, you know, Square One in Mississauga is again, you know, one of those store like malls where you will find those, you know, pretty fancy stores. You know, if you have to do those, you know, all day branded shopping, you have those options as well. So, you know, just talking about this neighborhood itself, like I said, great neighborhood, great price point. And as you can see, like, you know, slightly higher because of the new construction. And at the same time, the, you know, the proximity to some closer to, like, you know, great schools and some of the amenities. And so that is the wrap to this final tour of that $1.3 million range and the final neighborhood. I hope you did get some value. If you did, do consider subscribing and tap the bell for notifications so you can be the first to learn about the current market in Kitchener, Cambridge, Waterloo, and the surrounding towns. What I'm going to do before I, you know, end this video, I'm actually going to show you around this particular neighborhood so you get to see the other homes. And this is actually a new neighborhood, not quite mature and established. Even just looking at the trees behind me, you can see that, you know, they are fairly new and they're not that mature. So that tells you a bit about the neighborhood. But I'm gonna drive you around so you get to see some other homes in, and, you know, get a feel for the neighborhood itself. You know, like I said, once again, my name is Dharmik. I'm a real estate agent serving Cambridge, Kitchener, Waterloo. And I do get calls, texts, emails from people just like you looking for help in making their move to Cambridge, Kitchener, Waterloo, and I absolutely love it. So whether you're thinking of moving in 9 days or 90 days, give me a call, shoot me a text, send me an email, even schedule a Zoom call. All the information you will find in the description below so I can help you make a smooth move to Kitchener, Cambridge, Waterloo, and the surrounding area. Well, till then, I do hope to show you around town.